Hi folks, this is Checkpoint Quiz 10.6. All right, we're asked to simplify some expressions involving inverse trig functions. Letter A, we're asked to figure out the arc sine of the sine of 11 pi over 12. And you might say, well, sine and arc sine are inverses. Isn't that just going to be 11 pi over 12? And the answer is no. Not necessarily, because remember the arc sine gives us values in a particular range of numbers. The arc sine of x, the range of that is minus pi over 2 to pi over 2. Now remember, we can associate real numbers with angles and radians. And so if I think of this from an angle point of view, the angles I'm getting out that have radian measure between negative pi over 2 to pi over 2 are going to be the angles in quadrant 4 and the angles in quadrant 1. So the negative here once again indicates the clockwise rotation. So I can associate, or I can call, the arc sine of the sine of 11 pi over 12. I'm going to associate that with some angle theta. And what do I know about theta? I know that the sine of theta has to be the sine of 11 pi over 12. But theta has to be between negative pi over 2 and pi over 2. So where is 11 pi over 12? If I plot that in standard position, as I go around the circle, that's 0. This is pi over 2, which is 6 pi over 12. This is pi, which is 12 pi over 12. So if I were to plot this guy in standard position, there's the initial side, and I would rotate almost all the way over there, and I would be left with a reference angle here of pi over 12. So where's this angle theta that I'm looking for? Well, the sine of theta has to be the sine of 11 pi over 12, and theta has to be between negative pi over 2 and pi over 2. Well, the sine of 11 pi over 12 is the y-coordinate on the terminal side of the angle where it intersects the unit circle. So if I'm going to have the same y-coordinate, that means that the theta is going to have to be over here. So this is my theta, and he's going to be in quadrant 1. Well, what angle is this? You can tell by symmetry up here. Theta is actually the reference angle for 11 pi over 12, which is just pi over 12 itself. So, what's the arc sine of the sine of 11 pi over 12? Well, that's some angle theta, whose sine is the same as the sine of 11 pi over 12, but the angle theta has to live between minus pi over 2 and pi over 2. That angle theta is none other than pi over 12. So the answer to part A is pi over 12. All right, in part B, we're asked to find the sine of the arc sine of 0.3. Okay, well, what is the arc sine of 0.3? I don't know. But I can associate this with an angle theta in radian measure. So if theta is the arc sine of 0.3, then theta's got to be an angle between negative pi over 2 with the property that the sine of theta is none other than 0.3. So if I look at this expression, what I'm looking for is the sine of theta. And what is the sine of theta? Well, I just said the sine of theta is 0.3. So, once again, the sine of the arc sine of 0.3. The arc sine of 0.3 is some angle who, by definition, has a sine of 0.3. So what's the sine of theta? Well, I just said it was 0.3. That'll do it for part B. All right, in part C, we're asked to find the cosine of the arc sine of 0.3. All right, so first thing we do is we're going to associate the real number arcsine 0.3 with an angle theta in radians. Where, by definition, the sine of theta is 0.3, and theta has to be an angle between 0 and pi over 2. What am I asking for? I want to know what the cosine is of the arcsine of 0.3, so I'm after the cosine of theta. All right, I know the sine of theta. I can get to the cosine of theta using the Pythagorean identity. So I plug that in. I square that out, and I get cosine squared theta is, plus, what's 0.3 squared? Well, that's 3/10 squared. That's going to be 9 over 100. So that's 0.09, which means cosine squared theta is 1 minus 0.09, which is 0.91. That means that the cosine of theta is plus or minus the square root of 0.91. Now, I look back to the range on theta. The arcsine gives me numbers between negative pi over 2 and pi over 2. Those correspond to angles, which are either in the first and fourth quadrant. Since we know the sine of theta is 0.3, positive, I know that theta is quadrant 1. So in that case, I'm going to select the positive square root. Right, so for my final answer, the cosine of the arcsine of 0.3 is the cosine of theta, which is the positive square root of 0.91. That'll do it for part C.